What's going on, everyone? Liz here from Learn Robotics, and I want to show you how to take an STL file and generate a G-code file for 3D printing. What you're looking at is Fusion 360. This is a 3D model of the Learn Robotics logo that I use to create keychains. And what you can do is go into the File 3D Print menu, and that'll bring up this sidebar, which will allow you to generate a G-code file and send it directly to a 3D printer utility. And I use Kira, so Kira is loading right now. It's pretty cool because now we've got our model already loaded into it. And then we can just go ahead and set it up. So I've got a printer profile already defined in Kira. And to do this, you'll just go into Settings, Printer, and then Add a Printer. And then you can go down to Other, select the printer that you're using or a model that's very close to what you're using. I have an ANA A8, which is a Prusa i3 clone. So we'll go ahead and we'll leave that the way it is. And that'll set up the printing bed, the size of the print area, and some standard settings for 3D printing. The next thing you need to do is check the profile. I typically print in draft quality. I haven't had a need to change this yet for the types of printing that I'm doing. Then I go into infill. So you'll check out infill. 20% is pretty typical. Anything greater than this will make the print more rigid. 10% you can get away with sometimes for smaller prints or keychains. Really just depends on what you're making and the strength of the material that you're going to be working with. Another key setting is the printing temperature. I typically will start around 200 degrees Celsius for PLA. I'm typically printing in PLA, so anywhere between 200 and 215 even degrees C is pretty good. You don't want to go too hot because then you'll just burn the material. But 200 is a good starting point. Whether you need to lower that a little bit or raise it a little bit, it's going to be dependent on how well your printer heats up and maintains heat. The next temperature is the build plate. So this is going to be your heat bed temperature. I'll do anywhere from 50 degrees C up to 80 degrees C, depending on the print. Typically around 60 is what I'll print at. And then print speed is just the speed at which the print happens, so the movement that the nozzle takes and how fast it moves. So sometimes slowing this down will make it a little bit cleaner of a print. You don't want to go too fast because then the movement of the nozzle will cause things to be shaky. So anywhere between 40 and 60 millimeters per second is pretty good. And then we can take a look at the supports. So supports you won't need unless you've got prints, you know, with overhangs that are extending over the base of the printer. You basically just don't want to print in the air. So what you'll do is you'll generate a support so that you're printing on top of a surface and not just floating in space trying to print something. So that's usually reserved for more complex prints. And finally, we've got build plate adhesion. Typically what I'll do is I'll do a layer of glass. I'll warm up the glass by doing a preheat cycle on the heating bed. And then what I'll do is I'll put down a layer of washable glue. So I'll take a glue stick, put a layer down, and let that warm up. And then once it seems to be pretty warm, I'll go ahead and start the print. And it usually starts with a skirt. And then once I have the skirt on there, the build plate adhesion has just been great. I haven't seen much curling. The objects don't detach as much. So that's just a really good methodology for how to have good build plate adhesion. It really starts with what you're building on. So once you're ready to go ahead and print this, you can also move this object around if you want to. I just have it in the center on here. This is a direct representation of where it will print on your 3D printer. You can go ahead and scale your model. You can rotate it. You can mirror it. You can do multiple modes. I don't typically touch any of these settings unless I want to duplicate and have multiple models in one print. But pretty much that's it. What I'll do is I'll click on Prepare. And this will do the slicing. It'll tell you how long the print will take, how many meters of filament you're going to need, how many grams of filament, and it'll potentially give you an estimate of how much it's going to cost you to print it based on the material specifications. You can set this up so that it's a little bit more accurate. I haven't gone into detail of that, but it's a pretty nice feature. So once you're happy with these settings, you can go ahead and click Save to File. I'm just going to save it in my CAD folder. And I'll give it a better name than this just so that I know what it is. I'm just going to call it Keychain. And you'll see that the file type is gcode.gcode. And there it is. So once you have this file, you can go ahead and take this G-code, save it to a flash drive, save it to an SD card, or use some sort of printer utility to move the file to your 3D printer. Select this file in the 3D printer and then start your print. Hopefully this helped you out. If you have any questions at all, be sure to leave a comment below this video, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial.